I'm Liz Cottrell, a geologist here at the National Museum of Natural History and director of the Global Volcanism Program. On March 11, 2011, Japan experienced a major earthquake. This was a magnitude 8.9, one of the five largest earthquakes ever recorded anywhere in the world. The islands of Japan are on the Ring of Fire. All around the Pacific Ocean, we have a lot of earthquakes and a lot of volcanoes erupting. That's because of the plate tectonic cycle. The Pacific Ocean is subducting beneath the continents. Let's pretend this hand is Japan, and this hand is the ocean floor. The Pacific Ocean plate is subducting or diving down below the islands of Japan. The force of those two plates coming together generates earthquakes all along this boundary. Sometimes these tectonic plates can slide past one another pretty peacefully, generating only small earthquakes. But sometimes parts of that boundary become locked. They don't slide past one another. Stresses build up on this margin over time and finally are released in the big one, and we get a rupture. This is what happened in Japan on Friday. Let's try to put the size of this earthquake into perspective. I said it was one of the five biggest earthquakes ever recorded. If we look at a map of Japan and show on this map the last 10, 25, and 50 years of earthquakes, we see a lot of earthquakes. Every dot on this map shows the location of an earthquake. The bigger the size of the dot, the bigger the earthquake. Now let's show the earthquake from March 11th. That's a really big dot. This earthquake was almost a magnitude 9. A magnitude 9 earthquake is 10 times bigger, an order of magnitude bigger, than a magnitude 8 earthquake. In fact, this earthquake off the coast of Japan was 1,000 times larger than the recent earthquake in Haiti in 2010. We've already discussed that the cause of this earthquake was the Pacific plate subducting beneath the islands of Japan. The motion of the seafloor during subduction displaced the water above into a giant standing wave, which then collapsed and sent out waves in all directions, like ripples on a pond. These waves move very quickly when out in deep water, but as they come ashore and the water gets more shallow, they slow down and increase in amplitude, such that finally the wave that came ashore was 30 feet high, crashed into the land, and then came back out to sea. Due to its long history of earthquakes, the population of Japan is highly educated about what to do in the case of an earthquake. People know when they experience an earthquake that a tsunami could be coming and know to run to higher ground. This likely saved many lives in the case of the March 11th earthquake. To learn more about earthquakes and eruptions around the Ring of Fire or anywhere in the world, visit us at the Global Volcanism Program and click on the link for the This Dynamic Planet map.